sorry, this question. A circular loop of radius 9.7 meter. Okay, so this is suppose the circular loop of radius 9.7 meter carries the current of 2.3 ampere. Obtain the magnitude of magnetic field at the center of the loop and at the distance 9.7 centimeter from the center of the loop, but on the axis. Yes. So see here, एक तो हमको सेंटर पे मैग्नेटिक फील्ड निकालना है, उसके लिए क्या फॉर्मूला है हमारे पास? बिल्कुल, we have the formula mu naught I upon 2R, simply. तो ये फॉर्मूला हमको यूज करना है, जिसमें mu naught के बदले आ जाएगा 4 pi into 10 raise to minus 7, which is a fixed value, we have to remember it, and into I, I मतलब करंट, जो कि 2.3 एम्पियर है, तो वो डाल दो यहाँ पे, और divided by 2 times of R, where R is going to be 9.7 centimeter, and centimeter has to be converted into meter by multiplying it by 10 raised to minus 2, right? So just solve this further and get it as, so 2 ones are and 2 twos are, so here it is going to be 2 into 3.14 into 2.3 as it is and divided by 9.7 kept as it is and 10 ke power agar combine karenge to ye 10 raised to minus 5 humko milega, correct hai? So this is going to be 10 raised to minus 5. Yes, just work out these calculations. 2 into 3.14 into 2.3 and that is to be divided by 9.7. So, देखो 2 into 3.14 वो तो हो गया 6.28. Okay, and that is again multiplied with 2.3, which becomes 14.444, and that is to be divided by 9.7. Comes out to be 1.489. So here it is 1.489 into 10 raised to minus 5 Weber per meter square, or we can simply say Tesla, which can be approximately written as 1.49 into 10 raised to minus 5 Tesla, which can also be approximately written as 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 5 Tesla. Yes. So here this is the correct answer. ये पहला हमको answer मिल गया. चलो अभी ये वाला try करेंगे. जो दूसरा उन्होंने बोला है कि at a distance of 9.7 meter from the axis, along the axis of the loop, from the center. तो ये 9.7 meter distance पे जो magnetic induction होगा, तो वो निकालने के लिए कौन सा फॉर्मूला हम यूज करेंगे? देखो याद होगा आपको, मैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन ड्यू टू सर्कुलर लूप एट अ पॉइंट अलोंग द एक्सिस इज गिवन बाय म्यू नॉट इनटू आई इनटू आर स्क्वायर, वेयर आर इज गोइंग टू बी द रेडियस ऑफ दैट लूप एंड दैट इज टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय टू टाइम्स ऑफ R square plus x square. इस distance को हम या तो x भी बोल सकते हैं, तुम्हारे textbook के अंदर हमने z बोला था. It's okay, it doesn't matter. You can call it as x and the whole square and the whole raised to 3/2 here. This is the formula. Remember. विशाखा तुम्हारा mic on है? Okay, so just use this formula here and try to find out the answer. See, mu naught ko hum replace kar sakte aram se, jo uska value humko already pata hai. Yes, so mu naught ka value kya aayega? 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 into I, current. How much is the current? Just take this question here so that we can read it carefully. Yes, current here is going to be 2.3, right? Yes, so it's going to be 2.3. So replace it here, 2.3, and multiplied by r square. R is matlab radius, no? So radius kitna diya hai dekho, 9.7 centimeter. So don't forget that it is going to be in centimeter. Okay, but dekho yahan pe ye jo r square hai, so r is going to be in centimeter. So r square will be included 10 raised to minus 4 here. ये समझ सकते हो? ये तो चलो करेंगे. क्या फर्क पड़ता है? 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 as it is, or whole square. Okay, and that is to be divided by 2 times of bracket में r square plus x square. अच्छा अभी r देखो क्या है, रेडियस जो कि 9.7 सेंटीमीटर है, और x पता है कितना है, ये देखो 9.7 सेंटीमीटर, which is going to be the same only. So we can just use it here and get it as 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 और उसका square plus, here it is again 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 और उसका square, और इन दोनों का addition और उस पूरे का power 3/2, that's it. So just simplify this further. Here this 2 can just get reduced with this 4, and we'll be left with 2 here in the numerator. And if we put this pi as 3.14, then we get this as 2 into 3.14 kept as it is into 2.3 as it is into, here it is going to be 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 ka whole square. Yes, and here in the denominator, this whole chunk and this whole chunk is going to be the same only. So it will just get doubled. So we can say this will be 2 times of 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 7 ka whole square and the whole raised to 3/2. So that in the next step, we can have this as 2 into 3.14 into 2.3 into 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 ka whole square as it is. That is whole divided by, अच्छा अभी 2 का क्यूब कितना होता है, देखो होता है 8, और उसका स्क्वायर रूट भी तो निकालना है. रेस टू 3/2 करना मतलब क्या, क्यूब करके उसका रूट निकालना, तो इसलिए यहाँ पे आ जाएगा 8, रूट 8. ओके, दिस इज रूट 8 एंड दैट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ दिस 9.7 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 7, और उसका अभी देखो यहाँ पे उसका स्क्वायर भी हमको करना है और उसका पावर 3/2 भी करना है, तो ये 2 कैंसिल हो जाएगा और यहाँ पे सिर्फ क्यूब बचेगा. और फाइनली अभी हम देख सकते हैं आराम से कि ये जो 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 का whole square इधर ही दिख रहा है, और ये 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 7 का क्यूब दिख रहा है नीचे, तो ये पूरा और ये पूरा कैंसिल हो जाएगा, तो सिर्फ नीचे एक एक्स्ट्रा बचा रहेगा, राइट? तो नेक्स्ट स्टेप में हमको ये मिलेगा 2 into 3.14 into 2.3 as it is, and that is divided by, अच्छा इस रेट रूट 8 को भी हम क्या लिख सकते हैं, 2√2 लिख सकते हैं. देखो तो ये बन गया 2√2 and that is multiplied with 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2, single एक ही बार बचा हुआ है वो. अभी यहाँ पे हम ये 2 को भी कैंसिल कर सकते हैं. ओके, और बाकी जो बचा उसको अभी लॉग टेबल से या कैलकुलेटर से सॉल्व करो फटाफट। तो देखो ये बच रहा है 3.14 इंटू 2.3 डिवाइड बाय रूट टू का वैल्यू हमको पता है ऑलरेडी 1.414 होता है एंड दैट इज टू बी मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 9.7 एंड दिस 10 टू माइनस 2 विल गो अप एंड इट विल बिकम 10 टू प्लस 2 राइट। सो फाइनली देखो यहाँ पे कैलकुलेशंस करने की बात आ रही तो 3.14 हियर एंड दैट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 2.3 विच बिकम्स एक्चुअली 7.222 राइट। सो यू कैन राइट इट एज 7.222 दैट इज टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय 1.414 मल्टीप्लाइड विथ 9.7 which comes out to be 13.7158. It's going to be 13.7158. And this is to be multiplied with 10 raised to 2. So if we divide these two numbers here, divided by 13.7158 comes out to be 0.5265. Okay, so it will be 0.5265. That is multiplied with 10 raised to 2 here. It is also in Tesla, but it can be written as 52.65 Tesla. Check. It's again different. See here we can also find it solve it by another method. Another method मतलब ये थोड़ा simplification करके हम उसको कर सकते हैं आराम से। देखो क्योंकि हमारे पास formula देखो क्या है, b is equal to mu naught into I into r square divided by 2 times of r square plus x square whole raised to 3/2. Okay, अभी but यहाँ पे क्या है ना कि उन्होंने जो दिया हुआ है r और x सेम ही दिया हुआ है, तो अगर हमने r के बदले x या x के बदले अगर r डाल दिया तो बहुत हमारा काम सिंपल हो जाएगा। तो यहाँ पे मिलेगा mu naught I r square divided by 2 times of here it is going to be r square plus r square again and the whole raised to 3/2 as it is, so that we can write it as b is equal to so mu naught I r square that is to be divided by 2 times of here it is going to be 2 r square ka whole raised to 3/2 right, and then we can get this as b is equal to mu naught I r square kept as it is that is divided by 2 times of 2 r square ka raised to 3/2. So 2 raised to 3/2 kitna banta hai? Again it is going to be root 8 and that is multiplied with r square ka 3/2 power kitna banta hai? R cube simply, so that we can just cancel this r square and r square from numerator and denominator and be left with this single r in the denominator, so that we get this in the next step, that is mu naught I upon 2 into 2 root 2 which becomes 4 root 2 into R. That's it. So if you put all the values here also, then also we are expected to get the answer. So it will be 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 which is as it is, multiplied with I, which is the current that is given to be 2.3 here, and divided by 4 root 2, and that is multiplied with R, that is the radius, which is going to be 9.7 centimeter, which is going to be in 10 meter by multiplying it by 10 raised to minus 2. Okay, so this 4 gets cancelled, and what we are left with is simply 3.14 into 2.3 divided by root 2, which is 1.414, and multiplied with 9.7, and that will be multiplied with 10 raised to, acha ye minus 7 bhi to hai na yahan pe, okay, 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 ye humne liya kya, ye liya hi nahi shayad isliye problem ho gaya, to 10 raised to minus 5 aa jayega idhar. Okay, and okay, so just work this out. You put 3.14 multiplied with 2.3. What is 7.222 here, correct? That is to be divided by 10 raised to 2 के बदले क्या आएगा, 10 raised to minus 5 आएगा बस. सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी 0.5265 एंड दैट इज मल्टीप्लाइड विद 10 raised to minus 5 टेस्ला, which can also be written as 5.265 into 10 raised to minus 6 Tesla. Whereas, उनका जो आंसर दिख रहा है तो वो है 1.68 into 10 raised to minus 6 Tesla, which should not be there. There must be some mistake they have done. So let us leave it. Go to the next question. Okay, a circular coil wire is made up of 100 turns, each of radius 8 centimeter. If the current of 0.4 ampere passes through it, what will be the magnetic induction at the center of coil? Once again, the same formula. Center pe tumko pata hai already, mu naught I upon 2R. Ye formula use hota hai. Jisme mu naught ke badle aa jata hai 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 as usual, and it is multiplied with current, which is going to be, ओके, ये बात यहाँ पे कि यहाँ पे उन्होंने बोला है कि नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स भी दिया हुआ है, देखो यहाँ पे, तो इसलिए फिर यहाँ पे फॉर्मूला जो है वो म्यू नॉट एन आई अपॉन टू आर ये बनेगा, जिसमें म्यू नॉट के बदले तो हमको डालना ही है 4 पाई इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 7 एज इट इज, और फिर एन नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इज गोइंग टू बी 100, सो इट विल बी 10 रेस टू 2 हियर एंड मल्टीप्लाइड विद आई, दैट इज द करंट विच इज गोइंग टू बी 0.4, right, and that is to be divided by 2 times of R, radius, which is going to be 8 centimeters, so it's going to be 8 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter, so that we can just deduce this 2 with this 4 here, so that we are left with, and also that this 2 can be reduced with this 8 by leaving behind 4, and 4 can be reduced with this 0.4 here, so that we can get this 0.1 only in the numerator here. So 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 7 and 10 raised to plus 2. And this 10 raised to minus 2 also goes up and becomes 10 raised to plus 2. So finally, we are going to get this as 10 raised to minus 7 into this is 10 raised to 4. And this is 10 raised to minus 1. 0.1 matlab 10 raised to minus 1. So this adds up to 10 raised to minus 3 only. 4 minus 1 is 3 and 3 minus 7 is minus 4. So 10 raised to minus 4 Tesla should be the final answer. Where this 3.142 comes from? Okay, pi to humne diya hi nahi na. Yes, pi to yahan pe aayega zarur. Pi matlab hi 3.14 hai. इसलिए यहाँ पे आ जाएगा नेक्स्ट स्टेप में 3.14 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 4 टेस्ला. ओके, गो टू द नेक्स्ट. Yes, see this 13th question now. For proton acceleration, a cyclotron is used in which a magnetic field of 1.4 Weber per meter square is applied. Find the time period for reversing the electric field between the 2Ds. Okay, time period for reversing the electric field. Matlab kya pucha hai unhone? Semi time interval pucha hai, t half. याद है जो कि हमको पता है ऑलरेडी स्मॉल टी जो होता है द टाइम इंटरवल बिटवीन द रिवर्सिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दैट इज एक्चुअली हाफ ऑफ द पीरियड ऑफ रिवॉल्यूशन. तो इट्स गोइंग टू बी एक्चुअली इक्वल टू कैपिटल टी बाय टू. राइट, कैपिटल टी अपॉन टू, ये हमको निकालना है. अभी कैपिटल टी के लिए क्या फॉर्मूला है हमारे पास, याद है? टाइम पीरियड के लिए, फ्रीक्वेंसी के लिए तो पता है ना आपको, लास्ट टाइम भी बताया था क्यू बी अपॉन टू पाई एम, बराबर है, इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो पीरियड के लिए फिर क्या होगा, उसका उल्टा होगा, इट विल बी टू पाई एम अपॉन क्यू बी. राइट, देन व्हाट विल बी द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ हाफ रिवॉल्यूशन, मतलब आधा आधा जो है, क्योंकि रिवर्सिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड के लिए जो टाइम लगता है तो वही आधा टाइम होने वाला है, पीरियड का आधा. तो वो यहाँ पे अगर डाल देंगे तो ये टू और टू कैंसिल हो जाएगा और हमको जस्ट मिलेगा पाई एम अपॉन क्यू बी. दैट्स इट. सो दिस इज द सेमी पीरियड एंड वी हैव टू पुट ऑल द वैल्यूज हियर. सो पाई के बदले यहाँ पे आएगा 3.14, एम के बदले मास जो है प्रोटॉन दिया उन्होंने, प्रोटॉन, तो प्रोटॉन का मास हमको पता होना चाहिए कितना होता है, वो डाल सकते हैं. चार्ज भी हमको पता है प्रोटॉन के ऊपर कितना होता है और मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वो तो ऑलरेडी दिया हुआ है इधर. यस, सो यू कैन जस्ट पुट ऑल द वैल्यूज हियर. यस, तो मास जो है, मास ऑफ द प्रोटॉन इज एक्चुअली 1.67 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 27 एंड दैट इज डिवाइडेड बाय चार्ज. चार्ज ऑन प्रोटॉन इज सेम एज द चार्ज ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हिच इज 1.9 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 19 कूलम. And magnetic induction is already 1.4 Weber per meter square, मतलब ही Tesla. Yes, तो ये सब क्या questions करो फटाफट. और ये 10 raised to minus 27 और ये 10 raised to minus 19, ये दोनों का calculation कितना आएगा, 10 raised to minus 8 आएगा, वो तो ठीक है. So this will be in seconds, okay? But here the calculations are to be done. तो देखो यहाँ पे 3.14 kept as it is multiplied with 1.67 which happens to be 5.24, okay, which is to be divided by 1.9 which is going to be 2.759 and this is again divided by 1.4 actually it comes out to be 1.97. Okay, 1.97. So it's going to be 1.97, which is approximately 2. We are doing something wrong. Formula to correct hai. Calculations वगैरह सब भी हमने calculator से ही किए. Might be they must have made some mistake. No doubt. Let us move to the next topic, next question. Just read the question. A moving coil galvanometer has been fitted with a rectangular coil having 50 turns and dimensions 5 cm by 3 cm. The radial magnetic field in which the coil is suspended is of 0.05 Weber per meter square. The torsional constant of the spring is 1.5 into 10 to the minus 9 Newton meter per degree. Obtain the current required to pass through the galvanometer so as to produce a deflection of 30 degree. Simply, we have to use the formula I is equal to C or K, we can say C upon N B A into theta. Yaad hai ye formula humne derive kiya tha galvanometer ke liye. To agar ye use karenge yahan pe to current kitna aayega? To dekho dikhe C kitna diya hai? C मतलब torsional constant है, तो वो दिया हुआ है 1.5 into 10 to the minus 9, but it is given to be newton meter per degree, correct है? So उसका unit है newton per meter per degree, और ये theta का unit क्या है? Degree है, so that will just get cancelled, and that's why it's okay if we put keep it in this same units, तो यहाँ पे 1.5 into 10 to the minus 9 as it is डाल देंगे, और upon into theta, theta kitna hai? 30 degree, correct hai? And that is to be divided by number of turns, which is 50, and magnetic induction, which is given to be 0.05, and area of the coil, which is given to be 5 by 3, matlab kitna ho gaya wo? 15 centimeter square, but don't forget to convert this centimeter square into meter square by multiplying it by 10 to the minus 4. So in the next step, we can have this 15 and 1.5 cancelled, leaving behind 10 here. So that this 10 also gets cancelled with this 30, leaving behind 3. So that we get in the next step, 3 divided by, what is this 15 to 0.05? Dekho, 5 into 0.5, matlab 2.5 ban gaya wo. So it is going to be 2.5. And that is multiplied with 10 raised to minus 4 here. And this 10 raised to minus 9 is already there. So if you simplify this further, then we get this 30 upon 25. And that is multiplied with 10 raised to minus 4. Sorry, 10 raised to minus 5 ampere. Which can also be written as, agar isko humne 4 se multiply divide kiya, into 4, into 4. So, upar mein aayega 120 upon 100. So, what is 120 upon 100? It's 1.2, right? Into 10 raised to minus 5 ampere, which happens to be actually 1.2 into 10 raised to minus 5 ampere. This is actually going to be the current in this coil. Okay. Chalo, theek hai. So, let us stop here. कल हम ये सारे न्यूमेरिकल्स खत्म कर देंगे, अभी थोड़े ही बाकी है, सो उसमें से कुछ आप करके रखो सो दैट यू कैन कंटिन्यू विद द डाउट्स एंड रिमेनिंग न्यूमेरिकल्स. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू.